on our pickup for the box kick, let's just try and leave our hips slightly higher so that the transfer to our kick is a little bit easier rather than getting into like that full halfback position that we see on the box kick.
I've just got a question. As a nine, what would you say is the best way to practice box kicking? More kind of blocked practice, doing the same kick, same distance over again, or kind of more kind of from the base and then changing the distance and varying it more, or instead of doing the same kick over and over again, what would you say would be the best way to practice it?
Lately it's the five stages. So I'll go through them sort of quickly. So the first stage is front on, and these kicks are all at 80%. So front on, literally just getting some nice hang time to whoever you're kicking to. So literally on this angle. And then you progress to 45. So can I be accurate in dropping the ball on the same point? And then you take it to 90 degrees, so side on, which is where we want to get to with the box kick. And we're focusing on kicking up, but then that slight rotation of the hips. So we get up and let our hips get through to target. So we've gone front, 45, 90. And then the stage four is getting to 90 degrees from a standing position from here. So ball here, pulling out, getting to 90 and kicking. And then stage five is going from the ground. So from the ground into that full 90 degree box kick.
Okay,
So
that's great. Thank
all
you.
that's going to do there is just tell your foot, tell your body what's really important, which is kind of that kicking position that you want to get into, which is that tall body, strong kicking
Yeah.
up.
Because I do a lot of practice, sorry, out of hand box kicking, not so much off the ground. Would you say do one more of the other, or kind of obviously do both, or?
So the thing that always mucks halfbacks up is that transfer from ground to the kick. So one cue that I have had a lot of success with is on your pickup, let's see if we can leave our hips slightly higher. So if you think about when you do a squat in the gym, we're looking for sort of below 90 degrees. On our pickup for the box kick, let's just try and leave our hips slightly higher so that the transfer to our kick is a little bit easier, rather than getting into like that full halfback position that we see on the box kick, because there's a lot of room for margin of error and angles. Would be my advice on that.
Okay, oh, that's great. Thank you very much.
No worries. Hey team, thanks for watching that Rugby Bricks YouTube video. Please subscribe to the channel. I want to point out the four passing sessions we have put together. What it is I coach you through these four sessions, 60 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest for 10 exercises. I coach you through, give you the cues, the tips. These exercises are drills that the professional use to keep their passing game sharp and keep developing their skill set. So I'd love for you guys to check these out. The link to these four sessions is below. I guarantee if you get through those 100 passing sessions, those really important coaches and selectors are going to really notice your skill standing out on the rugby field. Thanks for watching again. I'll see you back here again for another Rugby Bricks YouTube video.